My real name is Vasilis Galliouras. The nickname is GoriLLakoS, actually means little gorilla in Greece. And the country is Greece. I just finished high school. I didn't go to university. I was at the robotics university, but I wanted to work. I was working for hardware. I was a salesman, then a product manager. Now I run my own company with distribution. You know, I was destroying my PC always. I didn't have money to fix it. So my father told me, the next time you're gonna break it, you have to fix it. I started reading forums. They were very famous by then. So I met Hypro. And Hypro was an inspiration for me. So I started, he was a lot bigger, sorry Hypro. So I started overclocking. It was for our own happiness and for our own creativity. Because before 10 years ago, we didn't have extreme cooling, we didn't have liquid nitrogen, neither dry ice. We were building our own phase changes or cascades. There were no hard mods. I mean, we were making our own hard mods on VGAs, on motherboards. There was FSB wall by then. My best big pick on OC career, I don't actually have. I enjoyed very much playing with AMD FX53 and 55. I think I had the world record on CPU frequency. I don't think it's still the best score, but I was overclocking for fun. I was not competing. Overclocking nowadays, it's different from the old days, but you know, it's the new generation of overclocking. I don't like it, but I cannot blame it. Now it's more like if you have contacts or money enough to spend, because it's a very you have to have a lot of money to participate. In the old days, you wanted, of course, money and contacts, but not as now. You also need to have skills, tweaking, hard mods, reading, everything. But as everything, it is changing, so we have to follow this. Yes, base level is getting more and more famous every day. We have to help them, and when I say help them, to grab them from their hands and show them how to insulate the motherboards, that liquid nitrogen is not gonna harm you if you use it wisely. And even if you teach 100 people and you just make one extreme overclocker, I think it's already a very good thing for our community, because it's also very hard. Overclocking, it's not an e-sport. In e-sport, when I say e-sport, I mean it's gaming. Actually, everybody can game. Everybody can play. Some are better, some are not. But overclocking is not just an e-sport. You need to read things, to buy things, to destroy things, to test things. Maybe destroy your own very expensive things that then you cannot even automate it after this. So I think if e-sport is here, overclocking is 100% up. It's like the Formula One of car challenges. Winning money and contacts. But I bet that if an old overclocker starts playing again, and he has money, contacts, and time, I think he can beat them very easily on lower clocks. This is why I think you have to make the Pro C League with cap 2 megahertz, so people will start getting involving again about tweaks, because now it's not about tweaks, it's about I have the best contact in Intel, or I have the best motherboard, the best bin drum, the best bin VGA, so I'm first. And this is a problem for the low end, because if the mainstream overclockers are seeing the sponsored, they just don't try, they give up. They say, I will never go like them. 5 years from now, I really want to see the community to be one family. I don't know why, I don't know how, but I also want to see that we will have again passion, and it will be not a matter for money or winning, it will be a matter of overclocking. I like to overclock. I would like to see a better organized Pro Cup, like, let's say, football league, with real teams, with time to rest, with all those things. And companies, I think they have to support better the teams. Don't know, maybe I'm romantic. I don't know. If you were a new overclocker, I would highly suggest you to try all the levels one by one, starting from water cooling, maybe then build your own phase change or your own pots, because you need to experience it. You need to have experience with the thing you love, so you will be one and go stage by stage and eventually go to liquid nitrogen. But before then, you have to be polite with everybody and love this sport. Regarding Taiwan, it's my fourth time here. The first time was at MOA 2007. I like it very much. I like it everything. They are westernizing like a virus, the people here. I don't know if it's good or bad, but I like it. I don't like the humidity. Too much humidity.